everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Miss Whitney's Beauty Shop, episode 16. I am so glad that you all enjoyed yesterday's episode where we created Gumby from the Gumby TV show. I am so thoroughly pleased that you all enjoyed the way Gumby came out because I totally went into it blind. I did not know how Gumby was going to come out, but I am very pleased that he came out as handsome and as he did. And I do plan to share him and the crew as soon as this is done. I have a lot of Sims that I've created in this series that I have yet to share, and I need to share them on the gallery, but they will most definitely be there. I just got to remember to do it, but they will be there, most definitely. I know Gumby will. So I will definitely share that for you guys to download him and make green babies or whatever it is you decide to do with Gumby. But today, we will be making Gumby's friend, Goo. Goo is actually a magical mermaid, and she is so cool. Goo is sort of like the mother figure, if you will, of the band. She has super awesome powers. Even though she's a magical mermaid, she doesn't do anything foul in the show, like no witchcraft or anything like that. Goo actually has pretty neat fighting abilities, actually. Whenever Gumby goes on adventures with his friends and they run into some sort of rivals, especially the blockheads, she has the ability to spit out blue goo balls in the faces of the enemies to blind them. And when she needs to capture them and hold them so that Gumby can take them into the authorities or whatever the case may be, she can spit out these blue goo ball string things that can wrap around the enemies and capture them. So it's really cool with the abilities that Goo can do. But outside of that, Goo likes to bake pies, and she's, again, like I said, part of the band, and she can play on the keyboard, which is primarily the instrument that she plays, but she can also play the guitar and a number of other instruments that she can do. I mean, every time we see an episode with them, they're playing something different. It's almost like they can play every instrument in the world, almost. But it's awesome what Goo can do. She's super cool. She's not that annoying side girl character that's part of the group of guys. She just is awesome, and she will put you in your place if you test her. I love that about Goo. So today, that is exactly what who we're going to create today. And I am going into this blind, just as I did before. I got a random Sim here, and her face and everything seems to fit the construction of what I'm thinking of for Goo, because Goo seems to be a plus size girl, even though she's like a little blue blob, actually. But she seems to be a plus size girl, and so we're going to be making sure that we deal with a plus size blue lady that's going to fit the overall vision that I have for Goo. So why don't we just not wait and jump start and get into creating Goo.
So baby, tell me, can we talk?
Girl Goo. I am very, very impressed. Blasted mouse. I am very, very impressed with how she came out. I slapped on some beautiful eyelashes on her, which is CC. I did some shaping for her, and I kept her plus size. I would love for her to be more plus size, but based on the show, she looks like she's not a big girl, but she looks like she's, you know, one of those, what's the best way I can put this? She's a plus size girl, but she's not so plus size, but she's got a shape to her, put it that way. So I was trying to keep to that shape, more like a moon shape. And so she's definitely a plus size girl, and that's what I kept with looking at the figure I got of her, and gave her a little booty right there, and kept everything as symmetrical as possible. And I love where it's at right now. I love where everything is. And she looks perfect. She looks absolutely perfect. Who'd have thought that blue skin would look so beautiful? The skin is CC. The skin that I'm using is not the skin that I was using for Gumby. It's actually by somebody that I cannot call for the life of me. I think I cannot call it because once you click on it, it disappears. So I cannot call it. If I can remember what it is, please let me know or remind me in the comments to put it in the description. Or if you ask me in the comments, let me know and I'll put it in the comments and you just find it. But whatever it is, it was perfect. I just picked the blue default skin and this cover up here. I think it was like a cover up or overlay. And it made it look more powdery, more just soft, pastel. And it just looks really good. It looks really, really pretty. She doesn't look crazy. Other than the fact that she's blue. But changed her eye color. I didn't want it to be crazy. I wanted it to look as human as possible. No crazy blue eye color. So this is all default eye color. It's not CC. So she just looks really great. So let's just go ahead and get into her makeup. Because that's what I'm really hoping to jump into. But before we do her makeup, let me get her hair. Let's see here. Now Goo has long blonde hair. Why Art Clokey gave her long blonde hair, I have no idea, but he gave her that, so we are going to stick to that. However, I don't want it to be so blonde. In the show, her hair is a yellow yarn. So it's very, 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 very yellow. Very yellow. But we're not going to go so yellow because it's going to look very weird. So if I'm going to go humanoid here, I got to go with a soft, almost sort of a platinum yellow or an eggshell yellow or something. And she has long hair. And I was going to go with a long hair with her. And this was the yellow I was going to go for. This was, or this. No, actually that's not gonna work. So something, this was actually what I was looking at. This is what I was looking for. So I didn't want to go so yellow, you know. But I kind of want to step out of the realm with her hair. I kind of want to go short. Because when in the 60s version, her hair was kind of pulled back. It was long, but it was kind of pulled back. Almost like this. It was almost like that. But when we got into the 80s, he put her hair down to where it was over her shoulders, almost like this, with a bow on top of her head. So I'm looking up and down because I'm looking at the figure, and I kind of want to go short. Not so long, but I don't want to go shortcut. I want to go shoulder length. And I'm looking here. She also has a white bow on her head, and I'm trying to go... That actually really looks good, actually. I was getting ready to say, to finish the thought, I was going to go with a blonde with white tips or something like that, where the, you know, one of the hairs where you can do, like, different colors. Like something like this. Okay, that looks good. But if I was doing a different sim, that would work. Ooh. I really like that short hair, and that's from Get Together right there. That's actually really nice. That's actually really, really nice. Now they had a short hair that looked braided because her hair is yarn, but it means her hair is braided. Oh, it would have worked, but I really like that short cut, to be honest with you. To be totally honest with you, I'm not gonna lie. I actually like that. I actually like that because everything else is not standing out to me. I really like that cut. That really looks good on Goo right there. And that's a Get Together hair. Also, I'm being very distracted right now. I hear my chickens in real life out there squawking. It's about noon right now. It's actually time for them to eat, feeding time. And that could be them calling for me now to come feed them. Yeah, I like this right now. Yeah, so this hair in particular is very, very nice. Now, this one would actually work. This one looks more like a yarn, and it could work. It could work, but I like the other one. I really like the other one. I like the short, and this is really cute. I wish I could put a white bow somewhere. I mean, it would really, really fit the bill here. I will take a look real quick to see about hair accessories, but it's just hats. It'd be nice if we actually had hair accessories, you know, like bows or barrettes or, you know what I'm talking about, like, you know, bobby pins or something like that. It'd be nice. But anyway, let's get into the makeup. This is the piece resistance. This is what I'm looking forward to. Now, because she's magical and because she's in a band, last night I went to bed excited about this. I was really thinking about how to go with her makeup. And I do want to keep with a magical sense, but in the sense of not making her look crazy, but the fact that she's in a band. I want her makeup to be subtle, but sort of dramatic. Not so dramatic to where she walk around looking crazy. Now, some of my favorite makeup is actually this one. This one is actually my favorite. Wonder what it looks like blue. That was really cool, actually. What does it look like white on her? Oh, that's so freaking amazing. Okay. So I said I wanted something dramatic, and I didn't want something so dramatic that it took away, but I really like that. It's one of my favorite eyeshadows. I don't deal with eyeshadows too much, but I really like that one. And these two are my favorite, too. These right here, the ones that do this. Ooh. Oh. Ooh. Okay, this one's fine. I like this one. All right, don't touch nothing else. No, nobody move. Okay, now eyeliner. All right, we might do a little bit of eyeliner, subtle eyeliner. So I'm going to use some CC eyeliner here, and I want it light, very light, very, very light. Let me go down the line here, very light. Very nice. Very nice. Wait, hold on. I might look a little dark around the corner. Wait a minute. Okay, that's good. Yeah, that's perfect. Very nice. Oh, I like how this is going. I don't think I'm going to deal with any blush because I don't have any blush that fits her blue skin. Everything else I got here is pretty much for dark skin other than this particular blush. But see, it's dramatic. If we had blush like this, that fit the whole cheek without the dots and the you know, the craziness up here, fine. Now we can see what this looked like. Now this might work. Let's see what that looked like. Oh, well, that gives it a little bit of blue tint, and that's not bad. That's not bad, but I think I might keep it natural. We'll keep it natural. The only dramatics I want happening is with her eyes. I want you to be drawn to her eyeballs. And I want you to be drawn to her lips. Now, her lips, I know I want something crazy here. I really do. Now, we can definitely use some in-game lips here. Now, because they have some beautiful lips to play with, especially these lips right here. These two in particular I want to play with. Especially this one here. This one's nice with the one stripe going through the lip. I like that. I want to play with the CC lips I have. Now, this one in particular, I've downloaded a few since then. So, I think I know exactly what it is that I'm looking for. Right here in these lips, that's it. That's actually it. Oh gosh, I don't know who this is though. Okay, I know what it is. It's right next to all these right here. It's another one of the skin that I was using for Gumby, the Remus Sirion. I have the hardest time saying that Simmer's name. Remus Sirion lips. I believe that's who it is. It might be somebody else, but I think it is somebody else. But whatever the case may be, that's Simmer's lips. It's CC, and that's the blue lips I'm looking for, right there. It's a soft, glossy lip. It's beautiful. I love it, and it makes her look kissable. It makes her look cute, because Gil is cute. So I really, really like that. Let's see here. Since we can't give her a white bow, I'm going to go ahead and jump in here and give her some earrings. We can sort of see her ears there, so I'm going to go in here and give her some hoops. I always tend to go for the hoops, and I'll make them white. That'll compensate for her not being able to have the white bow, and that will give her the white hoops instead. So she is looking really, really cute right now. I am very, very pleased with this. So now let's go ahead and give her a dress. Now, that was the one thing I knew I wanted to give her last night before I went to bed. I was like, she's got to have a dress, and the dress that I was thinking of has got to have polka dots. And I know I'm not crazy. There's got to be a polka dot dress in here because I feel like I saw it. I saw that dress. And I don't know where it is anymore. Well, there is something with polka dots on it. Now, if I can't find a polka dot dress, and I don't want to sit through here with you all on here looking at me trying to find this dress, I'll have to give her something with stripes. But I really, really want to give her dresses. And I don't want to sit here going through all these palettes trying to find a dress. Now, I can compensate with something else, but I really, really want something with polka dots on it. All right, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep her. She's more of like that girl next door. I think I'm going to keep it simple and go back to the dresses. And I'm going to keep it at the one dress that I was talking about. This one, I actually looked at this one. This one came with seasons. It's actually very cute. And this is actually very, very blue. And this is very, very nice, actually. What about the light blue again? No. It's got a contrast. It's got a contrast against her skin. But I really like the white dress, though. The white, just the white, what would you call that? Is that wool? It's not polyester. My chickens are so loud right now. They know how to find me on what part of the house I'm on, and they get to my window and they start. That's my girls out there at the window making noise. My goodness. All right. Let's see. I kind of like that. All right. I think I'm going to stick with the white. I'm going to stick with the white and just do white on white because her blue is everything. And then I'm going to give her some sweet shoes. She doesn't wear shoes in the show because she's a mermaid. So her feet are very much like fins. Very wide fins. Almost like a whale. Almost like whale fins almost. And I want to give her some white heels. I feel like she would wear flats, honestly. She wouldn't wear heels. She would wear flats. Let's see if we can stick with that. Does he come in flats? I don't like the stripes. Does these come in white? I don't like the black. Darn it. If all those that came in freaking white, straight white, it would work. What about this one? Does these come in white? They do come in white. I kind of like it. You know, it's simple. I like that. Now let's give her some accessories. I think I like the beaded bracelet. We'll keep that in white. I'm not going to put anything on her other arm. And honestly, I think I might give her a necklace. Before we call it quits, I'm going to give her a necklace. This seemed like something she would wear. No, actually, this would seem like something she would wear because she's a mermaid. It looks like a pearl. There. Fine. Perfect. She's gorgeous. My chickens have me so distracted right now. And I also have so much to do today off the PC, so I better just go ahead and get started today. But there we go. Our girl, Goo, is finished. She's done. I wanted to keep her simple. My primary focus was really trying to get her created because I had a vision of how I wanted her to look as magical as possible in her makeup. And I really wanted her to show that she had some sort of just something different about her that made her look unique, and I really liked the way she looked, and white was definitely her color because, like I said, she has a white bow, and that just showed purity about her. White is purity, that's what it means. So I definitely like the way she came out. Her outfit is simple. She's that girl next door. It says that she's sweet, just like she is in the show. And I love that she's plus size. She has curves. I mean, I love the way that Goo came out. Her hair is not too yellow like the yarn. I mean, it's just perfect. It's subtle. It's perfect. I am very, very pleased with Goo. So if you enjoyed this episode, please leave a like, leave a comment. Most definitely click that bell next to my name so you will be notified for the next videos of Miss Whitney's Beauty Shop. The next episode, we will be making possibly Prickle or Goo. I have not decided yet. Thank you all so much again also for giving me great ideas for the next theme for what we're going to do. I'm enjoying this so much. You all are giving me some great ideas. I'm just having a ball. And I hope you are too. So I will see you in the next episode of Miss Whitney's Beauty Shop. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure you click that like button and share it with your fellow gamers. If you're new to the channel, make sure to subscribe and click that bell next to my name to be notified of future uploads.